Hey, fellow agents, this is Agent Smith, and this is video number, episode number two, of Mad Max. So, we have reached to, we've gotten the assistance of Chumbucket here, who's basically gotten us to his home, which is inside this rust bucket of a ship here. And this is his Magnum Opus, which he intends to help us to find. This is what I was discussing earlier. As you've seen from the previous video, as much as we had looked at and the size of the vastness of this, and then you take a look and see how much more. So I was stating before, this is built on the Just Cause 2 engine. So, okay, Jeet and Gut Gas are the two local areas, that's why they were mentioning them. I don't know where I'll find everything in all the different cities in this place. Everything is undiscovered. Got some locations. We do have a gas town here. Deep Fryer. Supposedly the Thunderdome is out here somewhere as well. Anyhow, so it's a vast space that we're in as it is now. You're going to see from the driver about to make across the thing, and this whole world is just huge. So, there's so much to check out. Scavenging locations. Things will pop up all over on here. Even the map I'm on in the Outer Greaves kind of have camps and scarecrows everywhere, but before we get exploring, let's go ahead and forward on with this mission.
We're low on fuel.
No shit.
Unfortunately, with gas time comes the blessings of Guzzlee.
Guzzlee.
Enough fuel for us to make it to the graveyard.
Where? Oh, okay. Mission change. Alright, let's pull up here.
Over there! Fuel cans!
See what we can find.
Empty.
Right, nothing. There's some scraps in here at least. Always got to check for whatever we can find. 100% location. You'll probably notice that I'm a bit of a perfectionist, and it's very unlikely that I'm going to push forward in much of the story.
Along with anything of use.
I tend to want to make sure that I've cleared anything that I find.
A big steel gift box. What prizes do you hold?
Convenient.
She's out of gas.
Alright, you wanna do this?
Oh, you win! What a great county! You may refuel and demolish!
Yeah. There we go. Collect the loot off of this guy. Oh, good, we can loot everyone. Find any scraps we can find around here as well. There's a can, but before I take it... ...100% collected. What else you got? Nothing else? Just another roadkill camp.
Okay.
Huh, it just regenerates. How useful is that? Refuel.
Hillera! All the way to the brim!
There we go. No, refueling. You can ignite these and throw them, huh? That's actually pretty cool.
Now, let us make haste before the nightly hunters return to their lair.
All right. Oh shit. Lag fucking dragged me right into that wall. This car drives like an ice block on the sand. I know it all looks like sand, but there's actually a difference between the road and the actual sand. Man. Dangerous drives. Alright.
So let's make this one count.
Alright. So he gets right to repairing. Anytime you have any damage or anything like that, that's, he goes to work fixing your vehicle for you. You see my repair meter on the lower right hand side of the screen. Increasing. So as long as you're not moving, he's fixing your car for him. Night and throw.
Oh. Exaltation. She's cracked open.
Now it's time to get ourselves a new body.
Murder on sight.
Let's take a look at these bios. Missed one back there. Outer Graves, Chum's Hideout. No, this is a graveyard. It's a place of cultural significance for the Buzzards. It seems that they keep their car bodies here before transforming them into war machines. Apparently, they do not dare bring these car bodies down into their tunnels before their transformation. The Buzzards are very superstitious and believe that such car bodies might have negative influence on some metaphysical plane before they have been cleansed by spiky transformation. It is also from this place that many Buzzards launch their nightly hunts across the wasteland. The place is barred up and heavily booby-trapped. Only when the Buzzards are out of their hunts, out on their hunts, can someone enter, but at huge peril. I think I had a couple more. Clear these out. Magnum Opus.
My life's work. She is the angel combustion, becoming flesh. Steel, as it is. Since the angel combustion sent me the warrior's angel, I am sure of my destiny.
Which is the fastest, meanest, most outstanding one-man survival vehicle ever built in this wasteland. Although, I suppose technically with the help of kind of two men, but the guy I found earlier was a scrap of him. You don't scare me. See, this fist is going down your throat. Among their chaotic ranks are the groups collectively known as the Roadkill. The Scrappa are definitely the weakest and least skilled in combat. They are young fighters trying to prove themselves alone. They are easy pickings, but they often choose to attack in large numbers. So, let's see. And last, another item for me. Max can fuel his use fuel cans to fill up his car, save extra fuel, and or use them in the form of explosives to remove obstacles, kill enemies, etc. They'll also be shot from afar. Alright, back to it. Into the graveyards. That's fine. I'm gonna avoid touching any of their stuff.
There's dangling man killers everywhere. Tread careful.
This is gonna be fun to drive back through.
Watch out.
There.
More traps ahead.
Not really well hid. They're kind of lit brightly. I think I'm gonna just drive through all of them. Defeat 8 enemies in 1 melee. Is that a challenge? Drive in this game all over again. Man. Come on, camera. There we go. I know we mustn't, but I need you to repair this vehicle before I keep moving forward. Well, that was stupid. God damn it. Yeah, I'm not a good driver. There we go. Yeah. God damn this lag, dude.
Get the car in place down here. I'll lower the body onto it.
Yes. She'll be ready. That's how you will.
Oh, yeah.
Something here.
Yes, there is. This is 3 scraps for me to get.
Maybe I could zip down this.
Using a pipe gun.
Flashlight. In.
It's like, what the hell is he talking about? Oh, in this guy's body, okay. Boop. Just in case you wanted to know. Not being able to see your enemies is a great disadvantage at night or inside poorly lit tunnels. The flashlight remedies this.
Still works, too.
Yeah, it runs its own battery life, I think, but... Still also trying to find all of the caches of supplies I can get. Keep my eyes peeled for scraps. Oh, water. There we go. Yeah. Nice full health. My bride, huh?
Choose to get down here so we can escape with our skins.
Oh, just a second. Scrap's more important. All right. Hey, cat. Okay. Got some choices here. Show. Oh, what it actually looks like. Alright. So we got the furnace. We got the shovel face. And we got the wild hut. And a death rattle. Look, you either gonna lay down or get out of my way, buddy. Okay. The die roller. I like them all. I think for me, it's definitely between the die roller and the death rattle. Think. I think I'm going to start off with the death rattle. You can get these things changed at later points, so. Or more vehicles, maybe. Get a cat. Not good. Alright. Oh shit, okay. RB to evade attacks. There you go. Right there? Yeah, there is. Bam. Ooh. Of punish. There you go. Oh, I used my shiv up. Air punching everybody. Yeah, there we go. Is that all of them? shit. Alright, let's move out of here. Down. There we go. Are you as quick to put that body on? Oh shit. Alright, I guess we're going that way. Ah! Car combat, this is what I need to learn right now. Hold the left bumper and press B to aim at weak point spots with the shotgun. X and the left one to do side ramming. Okay. I'm going to do nothing unless I'm fucking stuck right in here. Oh, come the fuck on. Yeah. Uh-huh. I know. Trying. This is so bullshit. Alright. There we go. Yeah. I'm so fucked.
Shoot for the fuel tank!
Wow. How useful is that? Now, can I get through here without blowing my fucking car up? Oh, can you? Can't exit? Okay. This is what's happening right now. Fully expect that I'm not gonna make this. Just bust right out of the air. Ah. Bam. That guy came right out of the sand. There we go. Sweet Jesus. Get my car fixed immediately. Chumbucket calls it the Magnum Opus. It's not much of a car now, but it has potential. We found a body, but more work is needed before it's battle ready. No shit. Let's get this thing straight home. There, I'm stopped.
Oh. Get out there and fix it.
I'll hold up to that. Sweet, good to know. Yeah, he can turn this. At least put the fire out. Yeah. There's a lot to check out on this. We got buzzard enemies now, too, huh? Skinks are the lowest of the buzzard ranks, and they are numerous but less trained. And when not led into combat by a night lizard, they are put on more menial mining tasks and guard duty. They occasionally use subterfuge to hide under the sands, patiently waiting for their prey. Once their victims is close enough, they attack fiercely. We have the sand rattlers, quick and agile buzzard warriors that have been trained in fighting skills, and it's said that some sand rattlers used to be diglings that were trained to climb up into buried rafters and ventilation systems to locate buried loot. The work made them both strong and agile. And lastly, the Razzarattler. The most skilled and fearsome sand rattlers are given sharp blades to increase their deadliness in combat. These are some of the fiercest fighters you can encounter in the wasteland. This is their vehicle called the Barbacon. These are fast rolling rods. Always at the front lines of when the buzzards attack, they hunt smaller prey with abandon, but wisely leaves the sturdier victims to the heavy vehicles in the back. Barbacons can be found roaming the wasteland in smaller groups looking for scavenging opportunities. So that's all of them and the vehicles that we've seen so far. Plus another piece of equipment that I found, that shiv. Homemade fighting blades, very effective, but also brittle. That's why I could only use it once. It's wise to keep a supply of them. Speaking of which, by the way, there was this menu that got opened up earlier. As I complete missions and stuff through here, ones that I'm either active in or completed on, they give you a whole bunch of stuff. There's tons of challenges to be thrown at you, and anything that you complete as you go will get you stuff. Completing the five scavenge locations, as you can see. So there's goals to find things, and as you go, it increases your rank as a legend. So I'm considered roadkill at level 2 right now. And let me see. But anyway, as you go through them, Griffa, which will be someone I'll find later on, I think he was the one who said I wasn't ready yet, gives you the opportunity to do other things, like add points into these abilities to help increase your overall legend skills, you know, more health from your food, or acquiring water, more from water sources so you can keep your water up, increase your legend level by 1 automatically, things like that. So that's what this is about. Just completes, shows what you have on there. Defeat 8 enemies in melee combat in a row without taking any damage. So I hadn't been hurt before. And at that point, that had given me the untouchable ability. Alright, anyway. Let's get him going. I'm going to finish the repairs on this once we get there. So your vehicles actually have differences too when you're out in the wastes. If your vehicle is not built for the deep sand, you'll have trouble trying to drive through it, and you'll have better access and movement on the roads. Oof. You also have all the areas that we're in, as this states here, 1 camp and 3 scarecrows, which if I bring up the map on here, somewhere amongst all of this stuff are camps and scarecrows to check out. So, and as you get to other places, it gets bigger. Like, I could check out this area here before we head back to pick up some more scavenge some more parts, get ourselves some more challenges complete, and on top of that, maybe have some enough to actually build this, because all the scraps are what we're going to be using to build the vehicles as we go. God dang, this vehicle is not built for taking jumps. Scavenging location looks like it's right up the middle. Probably up on this hill. There it is. As he said, some nice metal gift boxes. Guys, for any scraps I can find, and take a look at find the 2 other ones that are hiding in here. Huh. Oh, there we go. Like, there's got to be more. Bam. Low-hanging fruit. Completed the scavenging challenge. And we're 100% located, looted. So if I take out my binoculars, I can actually take a look around. This is the point of having these. So you can see if there's anything of interest. Like that. If you find anything that shows up on your list. If you find anything, you might be lucky enough to actually... It'll tag it for you on the map, is what I was going to say. Distracted in my own statements. Alright, let's get back to the boat. Take care of this dog. So speaking to him, we'll start up the next mission. I don't think I want to do that just yet. I'm going to leave this one a little bit short. Take a break from this for a moment. So we can step forward into the next ones and see what we got. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and leave this video here. If you guys are enjoying what you're seeing, please feel free to give me a like. And if you're already a subscriber, don't forget to hit that notification button, the little bell, to give you the ability to actually see when I post my stuff up. I typically post 8 a.m. every day. So, alright, and I will see you all in the next video. Have a great day. Hey, fellow agents, don't forget to like and subscribe by clicking the button in the center of the screen. You can also find the last video by clicking the button to the left. And you can take a look at some of the other stuff I've done by clicking the button to the right. Hope you enjoyed the video, and have a good day.